Okay. That's far. Okay, here we're going to conduct another heat test for the Silmark fireproof coating. The coating is applied to the 1.5-inch styrofoam at 3/8 of an inch or 10 millimeter. Hooked up with this test, we have a heat probe placed on the back of the panel that will vary what the internal temperature is. Now, this test is going to run for a half hour. So a 10:40, we started at 10:43, so in 30 minutes we'll shut the temperature down and see what we come up with. The purpose of the heat probe placed inside the panel, I don't believe the coating will, the internal temperature will rise, but we need to know to what degree. A half-fire test with a blowtorch on it, I believe it'll actually quite well melt or deform 24 gauge galvanized metal, which we're going to do next. The torched flame tip is 1093 degrees centigrade or 1980 degrees Fahrenheit. This product here would be ideal to protect structural steel and or foam structures from deteriorating. The purpose of the EPS foam is we know that the foam will melt around 170 degrees Fahrenheit or 76.6 degrees centigrade. The test started, the internal temperature was 18.2 centigrade. So after roughly not quite 10 minutes, it's up to 33.2 degrees centigrade. After 10 minutes, the internal temperature is 50.6 degrees centigrade. during this heat test, the flame tip or the nozzle is 3 inches from the face of the foam. Under any conditions, that's a very severe test we're currently conducting. Okay, 76.6. That's the point where foam will melt. That's roughly about 18 minutes into the test. Okay, now the question is, after a full half hour, what would the internal temperature of the foam be? Test has another 12 minutes to run. We got 10 minutes to complete the test. The internal temperature of the foam is 93.5 degrees centigrade. Now this is very odd. The temperature probe seems to be dropping. The probe is in place. This is interesting. Now starting to climb a little bit, 92.9. Seven minutes left in the test. Okay, we're back up 94.5 degrees. Seems a little higher than that for some reason. Now it's dropping. Sorry about that. I guess it just timed out on us. Oh, the battery's on the other camera. We got 7 more minutes to go. Or 6 minutes, rather. I'm hoping we make it. There's no way you can plug it in the charger while it's going. Five minutes on the test and it's completed. I'm just hoping the battery lasts. If the battery should die on us, everything remains the same, won't touch it until we recharge. But hopefully it'll be enough to last the minute out. 4 minutes. Down to 3 minutes, or still about 3 minutes left. Three minutes left on the test. Down to 2 minutes for the test to complete. 1 minute left.
That's it.
Internal temperature was 98.2 degrees Celsius. Okay, we're gonna let this cool off a little second, which is about 208 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, now the next thing is to tear it apart and see kind of damage to the There's our probe right there. That's the back side of the board. Okay. Let's move this out of the way and see what we got inside here. I understand this is a very tough test. As you can see, the foam is still intact. I can hold my fingers on it, so this is very impressive. Okay, this concludes our test.